I find you very attractive. I'm just gonna say that. Oh,
very, there you go.
That's very nice. No, I'm serious. I'm a happily married man, but I've interviewed them all. I think this is one of the suavest, best-looking stars I've ever seen. I really believe that. Look at that guy.
Well, that's it. Good night.
Let's no, but you know what? You're, ahead.
But it's the thing is, you're also, it's the way you carry yourself. And I imagine
Thank you.
Were you always this way? Did you have a nerdy stage, or was a young boy, or were you just suave and debonair?
No, I think I don't know, I just scrub up well for an Irishman. What can I say?
I don't think that's true. I picture you on the playground at like 5 being like, hello, gentlemen.
No, I wasn't.
Shall we play
like
some
that.
Kickball, I think? helping the other kids tie their ascot.
No. I grew up on the banks of the Boyne in County Meath, Southern Ireland, a long time ago. And I lived a very kind of simple rural country life. Mm-hmm. I was brought up by the Christian Brothers, served Mass and did all of that, and then left Ireland in 64.
Right.
Went to London.
Right.
And,
poof, here you are, oof. Yeah.
Well, you know, a bit of luck and a lot of hard work.
And you know what? You also have, I think, the best hair in the business. I'm gonna say that right now. I care a lot about hair, and I think you've got
you
it
do.
Right there. Hey, look at that. That is amazing.
There you go. You can't see the join or anything like that. You can't see the lace.
Look what I can do with mine.
I can't do that. What'd you do? God, that's crazy. That's sick, man.
It's crazy. You know,
so
I was in Ireland.
What do you do in the mornings? What do you look like in the morning when you wake
this
up?
This is what I look like
you
when
do?
I wake up. It's completely messy, and I go, ha-bang, and it goes, ching, just like that. Oh. You know what's crazy? The last time I was in Dublin, I was walking down the street, and an Irishman stopped me, and it's an old man, and he looked up at my hair, and he said, good God, what do you feed that thing?
Yeah. Well, we should be so lucky that we
still
got it.
Exactly.
And still...
Well, you work with, have worked with some of the most attractive women in the business. Salma Hayek, Denise Richards, Famke Janssen, yeah. Jessica Alba, Halle Berry. I mean, good
it's,
God.
It's an honest living and it's a good job if you can get employment. And, you know, my wife calls it legal cheating.
Yeah.
She said it one night at a dinner party because someone was saying, said to my wife, how do you feel when you see your husband with all these women? And that was her retort.
Legal cheating. Yeah.
Whatever.
Well, let's talk about James Bond for a second. I've always thought you were such a fantastic James Bond, but there must be so much pressure. Once you've played Bond, you're Bond for life, and there's almost a pressure, you know, that in your everyday life, you can't experience the normal humiliations the rest of us experience because you're James Bond. Do you know what I mean?
That's not true, Colin. That's not true. I do experience them.
Well, I know you may experience them, but the rest of us, I'll tell you my story. I was trying to fly from New York to Los Angeles, and I was there at the airline counter ready to get on, and they announced the flight is canceled. And everyone just looks frustrated. And I look over, and Timothy Dalton, who played Bond before you, walks up to the counter, and he's just saying, you know, what can we do? Can we do something about this? I mean, they were like, nope, you can't do it. And I'm looking at him, I'm like, James Bond can't get this flight situation fixed. No, everyone else just walks, and then I just see him walking down the hall, like, it's just not fair, it's just not fair. And I thought, you know, it's pressure.
It can be if you want it to be pressure, but, you know, grace under pressure, as they say, as well.